On this particular day, Blake was at his auntie's house for school holidays, and unfortunately Blake had a couple of seizures and they called the ambulance. I rocked up there pretty much 10 minutes later, and Blake came to at that point, and he was pretty much hysterical, really. He was really upset, and he could see the ambulance people around him, so he was pretty scared. He knew that something had gone wrong. You know, I was trying to communicate with Blake and trying to get answers out of him, and they were asking me something and I'm asking him, and he wouldn't answer. But they were doing a great job. They did, you know, whatever they could at the time. And we got to the hospital, to the children's, and the nurse there just immediately started, you know, sign language with Blake, and he just stopped from being hysterical to taking notice of what the nurse was saying to him. And at that point I thought, oh wow, this is great that she could speak to Blake at this level. And a couple of days later I was looking on Facebook, and there was a survey there, and all I wanted to let him know that, you know, it would be fantastic if the ambulance officers could actually learn some sign. Even better if they had access to an iPad and the app that Blake uses, just to be able to communicate with him and just to let him know that it's going to be okay.
In our role, we attend a lot of families, people with disability and carers that require us to respond flexibly to meet the needs of someone with a disability. I think that it's probably more common than people realise, and this may be around communication, mobility. And as part of our job, I think that developing this accessibility action plan will look at ways with the community to make sure that we can do this better. The Accessibility Action Plan is such an exciting opportunity for Ambulance Victoria to work with the community to understand the needs and identify the gaps, as well as listening to paramedics and those all involved in the continuum of care for patients.
It's been great that Ambulance Victoria has given us a voice, and we've been able to participate and feel like we've actually been listened to. Now they acknowledge the fact that there is the need to move forward and look at different ways of being able to treat people like Blake.